up, my makeup-loving friends? Welcome back to 31 Days of Halloween. If you're new to my channel, 31 Days of Halloween is where I post a new Halloween costume makeup tutorial every day in October. Be sure to subscribe to make sure that you don't miss out on any of the fun. It's gonna be fun. Today is this reptilian sexy little lady. I had so much fun with this tutorial. I used some new techniques that I had never tried before, so if you want to know how to turn yourself into a sexy green little reptile bitch, just keep watching. I began by blocking out my eyebrows. I do this by running an Elmer's glue stick and a spoolie through my eyebrows. Then I powder over the top. I didn't do this because I wanted them to look gone, the way that most people do when they block out their brows. I just didn't want to get any adhesive into my brow hairs. I like having eyebrows. Then I wanted to make built-up brows and scales on my forehead. I had never seen this technique used before, but I decided to give it a shot. I saw my Model Magic sitting there and I decided just to put it on my forehead. Model Magic is a Play-Doh-like substance that I found at Walmart in a large tub for around like 15 bucks. My friend Jordan Hans, who is an incredible body painter, by the way, who's also doing 31 Days of Halloween, go check her out. She told me about Model Magic months back, and it has since changed my special effects life. It is such an easy substance to work with. It's feather light. It's a foam-like texture, but it molds like Play-Doh, and it's perfect when adhered to your face because it doesn't weigh down whatsoever. I adhered pieces to my face in the areas that I wanted them, and then I molded it on my face. Because I don't have access to sculpting and casting materials, this is a good DIY to make your own prosthetics at home. I used blunt-tipped sculpting tools, say that five times fast, and pressed shapes into the Model Magic on my face to make a scale-like texture, and then took it off and adhered it back on my face with Prozade adhesive. You can use liquid latex to adhere it or spirit gum, but I love the hold of Prozade, and I find it honestly just easier to remove. I sculpted the brows in a furrowed expression, brought the scales down the bridge of my nose, and squeezed shapes into them with my fingers. This product isn't fully dry on my face here, but it worked beautifully and stayed very well. Then I painted the entirety of my face, prosthetic, and chest in a green water-activated paint. Cream paints blend amazingly well over water-activated paints, like a frickin' dream. So I patted white cream paint into the high points of my face, such as my cheeks, chin, nose, and down on my chest, where my collarbones would be. I then contoured the hollows of my face with a dark green eyeshadow and added accents of yellow with a cream paint over the top of the scales and down onto the chest. Then patting some of that green shadow over the scales on the forehead and then highlighting over them with a white and yellow to give a more three-dimensional raised appearance. To further that three-dimensional appearance, I then took a dark black eyeshadow and a small detail brush and shaded into the cracks of the scales to make them look raised and deep. Using the same black shadow, I then shaded more on the sides of my face and under my double chin to remove that shit, optical illusion style. The shape you see me making on my chest is to look almost rattlesnake tail-like. I drew the shape on with black eyeliner and shaded along the outside of each curve, and then highlighted the center to give a bulbous larvae appearance. I just wanted a reptilian overall look, not one specific reptile. Then using a black eyeshadow and a small, flat lip brush, I drew on a scale shape, which is essentially just a bunch of little misshapen hexagons next to one another. Think squares and stop signs. I draw a bunch of them next to each other and shade them the same as you shaded the little bulbous neck piece, along the outside perimeter and highlighting each center. You see me build up the highlights with yellows, greens, light greens, and white cream paints at the end. I like to use my finger for this because a lot of the time your finger is just the perfect tool to use to tap out a product and really make a nice even blend. These are by no means perfect on me, but they give the appearance overall that I was looking for. Then I took some more of the same colored green paint that I did on the chest and drew in between it to clean it up a bit and then added a little bit of white highlight. Then with my signature black and green dots, you know how I love my dots, I added some more detailed dotting along the sides of the face and on the scales of my chest. Looking at the shape of an iguana's mouth, I drew on a black line extending from my lips to almost look amphibious. I drew on a winged liner and lined my upper and lower waterlines with a black eyeliner. I threw on a coat of mascara, some lashes, and painted my hair green with a cream paint, which, to be honest with you, I still have in my hair. And it's literally like 4 days later, so maybe use green hairspray, thank you so much. For final details, I popped in some cat eye contact lenses in the yellow cat color from camoeyes.com. And that, my little Halloween loving friends, is the finished tutorial. I hope you guys love it. This one was super fun for me. I love trying new techniques I hadn't tried before with the model magic on my face, and it stayed like a dream and is cheap as shit. I hope you guys like this makeup look. Make sure to tune in tomorrow and every single day this October for more Halloween costume makeup looks. Don't forget to subscribe to be notified when videos go live, which will be at 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. If you do decide to recreate this look, make sure to tag me on Instagram so I can see your work. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you at my next video.